गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 9th चैप्टर नंबर 3 एटम मॉलिक्यूल्स. स्टूडेंट इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर्स यू हैव लर्नड अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ मैटर एंड द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द कंपाउंड्स बाय द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्स. बट हाउ डू एलिमेंट्स कंबाइन टू फॉर्म कंपाउंड्स? डू दे फॉलो सर्टेन रूल्स एंड पैटर्न्स वाइल डूइंग सो? दीज क्वेश्चन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड द एशियंट फिलोसफर टू. स्टूडेंट्स एशियंट इंडियन एंड ग्रीक फिलोसफर बिलीव दैट द वाइड वेराइटी ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट अराउंड अस आर मेड फ्रॉम द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द फाइव बेसिक एलिमेंट्स. अंडरस्टैंड? यू नो वट आर द फाइव बेसिक एलिमेंट्स? अर्थ, फायर, वाटर, एयर एंड स्काई. सो स्टूडेंट देर आर द मैनी फिलोसफर लाइक इंडियन फिलोसफर कैनाद परमाणुस. कनाद वॉज द फर्स्ट व्यू दैट मैटर कंसिस्ट ऑफ द एटर्नल पार्टिकल्स आर कॉल्ड परमाणुस एंड द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दीज परमाणुस इन डिफरेंट प्रपोर्शन फॉर्म्स मैटर. सो स्टूडेंट द बेसिक आइडिया ऑफ ऑल दीज फिलोसफर वॉज ऑलमोस्ट द सेम. मैटर इज कंपोज ऑफ वेरी माइन्यूट पार्टिकल्स एंड अ वेरी लार्ज वेराइटी ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट कैन बी प्रोड्यूस फ्रॉम जस्ट अ फ्यू बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक. सो स्टूडेंट at the end of the 18th century when the Lavoisier, a French chemist, laid the foundation of the modern chemistry buying the formulating the two important laws of the chemical combination. So student there are the two laws of the chemical combination. Okay, so first is the law of the conservation of mass and second is the law of constant proportion. So student today we will discuss the law of the conservation of the mass. So according to this law thus there is no deductible loss or gain in total mass of the substance during chemical reaction. It means according to this law mass can neither be created or nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. There is no deductible loss or gain in total mass of the substance during the chemical reaction. So students suppose, understand what I am saying. So suppose we carry a chemical reaction AB. You can focus. There is a in a chemical reaction there is a chemical reaction between the A plus B. First you see, and if the product form when A react with B form the product C plus D. Understand? Suppose A gram of A, capital A, and B gram of B, capital B, react to produce C gram of capital C plus D gram of capital D. Then according to the law of the conservation of the mass, listen, small a plus b is equal to c plus d. Okay, understand what I am saying. So student this law can be verified by an experiment which was performed by the Lavoisier. He took a known weight of a tin in a retort. We will discuss later. First you see here the when A react with B it form the C plus D. If A gram of A and B gram of B react to the produce C gram of capital C and D gram of capital D, then according to the conservation of the mass both will be equal. A plus B is equal to the C plus D. Understand what I am saying? So according to this law that mass can neither be created nor be destroyed in a chemical reaction. Mass par kuch bhi effect nahi padega. Jitna mass before the reaction and after the reaction mass will be same. There is no deductible loss or gain in a total mass of substance during a chemical reaction. This means that okay Wait 2 minutes. Now you can see, this means that during a chemical reaction, the sum of the masses of the reactant and the product remains unchanged. So we will do some activity according to the conservation of the mass. Take some sodium sulfate solution in a conical flask. There is a conical flask, you can see here. So take the some sodium sulfate solution in a conical flask and some barium chloride solution in a ignition tube. You can see here is the barium chloride ignition tube. Now hang the just ignition tube in a flask by a thread and put a cork on the flask. Now we fix the cork on the flask. Now find the mass of the flask on a balance. You take the balance and then tilt the glass. You can see the tilt. What will happen? This sodium sulfate, when sodium sulfate Na2SO4 plus BaCl2, what will happen? This is a double displacement reaction, exchange of the ions. You will read in 10th class. So you when they mix together, when sodium sulfate react with barium chloride, what will happen? A chemical reaction takes place. And the sodium chloride, what will be formed? Sodium PPT of the sodium chloride. The chemical reaction takes place and the sodium chloride and the barium sulfate are formed. Okay, this is a double displacement reaction. This is the precipitate reaction. In this reaction, you will find the BaSSO4 white PPT. And you will find the sodium chloride in a solution form. So, again, first, balance this solution before the reaction. When you tilt this both chemical, what will you observe? You observe that the reaction will take place. Now, when you weigh this solution also, so what will you find? Then find the mass of the flask again. It will seem that sum of the mass of the reactants and product remain unchanged. Understand what I am saying? So if you take 1 gram this and 2 gram this, so 1 plus 2, 3 gram. And after the reactants, you find the 3 grams of this product. So it will seem that sum of the masses of the reactants and product remain unchanged. And in your NCRT book also, there is a two chemical also, a copper sulfate or sodium carbonate. Second mein humne barium chloride, ye wala humne example isme liya hai. Humne isme barium chloride liya hai, 1.22 gram. And sodium sulfate liya hai, humne 1.53 gram. Understand? So when you tilt this solution, what you will observe? The reaction will take place, and when you observe this, the mass remain unchanged after the reaction. So, laws of the chemical combination, laws of the conservation of mass state that mass can neither be created nor be destroyed. This means that during a chemical reaction, the masses of the reactants and product remain unchanged. Understand what I am saying? So, in your NCERT book, there is a page number 32. Here is a question. In a reaction, 5.3 gram of the sodium carbonate react with 6 gram of acetic acid. The product were 2.2 gram of the carbon dioxide. So, this is the in-text question answer 32.1. And so, what will you observe? This numerical show the law of the conservation of mass or not. Okay, there is a masses of given of all, and then you find the react product masses of the product. So you will find the masses will be remain changed after the reaction. So I hope you understand this laws of the conservation of the mass. What is the laws of the conservation of mass? Laws of conservation of mass state that mass can neither be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. There is no deductible, note any change in the mass of the substance during the chemical reactions. So I hope you understand. So next is the laws of the constant proportion. You can see, so according to the laws of the constant proportion state that in a chemical compound, the elements are always present in a definite proportion by a mass. So we will discuss in next video the law of the constant proportion. So I hope you understand this law also of the conservation of the mass. Mass can neither be created nor destroyed. It always be constant. Okay, students. Bye.